but the positive.
Buvuma, made up of 52 islands with a population of over 180,000 people, buzzes with activity, yet a trail of HIV infections is on the background. Members of parliament are back on the islands, but this time to solve a misguiding trend of using sex lubricants to avoid contracting HIV. Several women who couldn't speak on camera have used the lubricant being circulated. This was revealed during a health tour by the Parliamentary Committee on HIV and AIDS and Related Matters, which was attended by the District Health Officer, Beka Kanyike.
The support, and most of the support that moves them, especially for HIV, is basically from partners, especially Walter.
The World Health Organization emphasizes compatibility of lubricants with male and female condoms, but make it clear that lubricant is not a contraceptive and does not protect against pregnancy, sexually transmitted infections, and HIV. When Kanyike made his submission of the lubricants, legislators were shocked. Such misinformation is spreading dangerously and leaves both women and men exposed to HIV and other sexually transmitted diseases.
So whenever we hear lubricants, we can't worry, but I know in Bungoma,
now we are being told about lubricants, that someone who is HIV positive can use lubricants and doesn't spread to the other. And they are basically giving it to prostitutes or sex workers. So one government, Ministry of Health, to come out openly, so that the public can know that indeed there is another measure.
But with the lubricants, the scientists believe that there is less friction, meaning that even the spread can be curtailed. I don't know personally, as a person, whether it is effective or not effective.
To protect against pregnancy and sexually transmitted infections, the World Health Organization clarifies that the lubricant must be used with a condom. There are lubricants on the market meant to promote sexual health but not prevent the spread of HIV. A report on the state of health in the district shows that a total number active patients of HIV/AIDS is decreasing compared to 2022. But there are still challenges that hamper promotion of health.
This can't be concerned about the government. This concerned about the management of the facility. Because we have got the doctors and the management of the facility. You got the facility, the hygiene of cleanliness generally, you get the facilities so dirty to the extent that when you bring a sick person there, it becomes more sicker than even the way he came.
In Ivuma, it is different because all health center tools in Ivuma district have at clinics, and our people can access the ARVs and the rest. It is unfortunate that the structures where these health centers are being housed, most of them are dilapidated. They need refurbishment, actually.
In response, the chairperson of the committee, Harriet Businje, promised to address the challenges together with relevant authorities.
If it can be in the lubricant itself, such that it is not the risk in itself, that you just go and imagine that when you use the lubricant, you don't spread. But if there can be a substance, if our scientists can help us and they look at something like a substance, they incorporate it in the lubricant, I think it can be better.
Even if the lubricants were donated, the National Drug Authority has procedures of importing drug donation consignments in Uganda. And this includes the recipient institution of drug donations informing NDA of such need, the range of drugs and their quantities clearly stated and related to the population to be served, and the type of health facilities to manage the donation. And they must be subjected to the verification of drug imports procedure. The MPs pointed out a gap in sensitization.
And the facility management should wake up and clean the place. You find even the grass is everywhere on the verandas instead of cleaning. And you want the government to come and clean that?
Just last year, politicians expressed concern over the rising HIV infections on the islands, attributing it to immorality and poor access to health care. In a phone interview with the Commissioner for Health Services from the Ministry of Health, Dr. Henry Mwebesa distanced himself from the idea of using oil lubricants as a way to fight against the spread of HIV and AIDS. The Ministry of Health and UNAIDS 2023 district-level HIV estimates and projections revealed that Southern Buganda region took the lead with about 9,820 new HIV infections, followed by Northern Buganda recording a total of 5,730, Ankole recorded 3,990, Kampala registered 3,340, and was followed by Busoga. Uganda AIDS Commission in March reported a 37% decline in annual HIV and AIDS-related deaths from 27,000 in 2016 to 17,000 in 2021. And in the same year, new HIV infections stood at 54,000, which is an infection rate of about 0.12%. Report compiled by Marvin Mukasa for the news.